And so this presentation is more like a MVP, minimum viable presentation. So the topic is how do you lay a strong foundation for agile transformation based on experience for a particular client? And yeah, there are a lot of things to speak about it, but I'll try to speak the minimum. I try to close before 20 minutes so that you can extract information from me by asking questions. Let's make it interactive, but the first 10, 12 minutes, or maximum 15 minutes, I already set my time. You'll hear an alarm now at 12:45. Then I will speed up and then give time for questions. So this is basically an experience report presentation. Am I audible? Okay. So I'm Gopinath, I'm an independent consultant, and I've been in this process improvement field for the last 18 years, and prior to that, I was also in development and project management and all this stuff. If you want to know more about me, information is available there, so I'm not going to talk too much about myself. I'd rather talk about my work. Okay, the client in the question, these are some details about the client with whom I was engaged for an agile transformation exercise. And these were the five steps which we took to effectively initiate an agile transformation. Now, agile transformation initiation is one of the most crucial things. And it's directly, the success of any agile transformation depends upon how well it has been initiated. And these are the five steps which you do. Now, I'm not making a very tall claim that these five are the best possible thing and this will work everywhere. No, I'm not really making a tall claim. All I'm telling is what worked for this client, and it has also worked for me in a couple of more places. And this is an experience report presentation, that's all. I'm not going to make any what worked for me. That's what I'm going to talk about. First thing, setting the sponsor's expectations right. Now, you must be aware that many of the organizations get interested in Agile without really understanding what it is involves in Agile transformation. In what do they need to sustain the Agile transformation effectively? And in many a case, Agile may not be the right solution for your organization. It all depends upon the business you operate in, your work culture, your organizational structure. So many things comes into picture. And that's why it's a moral responsibility of any consultant or a coach to make the sponsors aware of these risks in an agile movement. So the first step which I took was setting the sponsor's expectations. So the very first question was, when we discussed, why are you going for agile transformation? What is so bad about the current situation? When I first talked to them, I really didn't find why they should go for agile. What business problem are you trying to solve? So these are the things which we discussed. And during the discussion, it came out that what client wanted was, he said he's in innovation space, and he wants a very quick, innovative, iterative solutions in the market so that they can remain competitive. This is instantly as a more than a 40-year-old company, so they are well steeped in waterfall culture, as I was showing in the previous slide. Now, that struck me as something which is, yes, client has got certain real reason to explore the agile perspective. Even then, I didn't say let's go for agile. I said, okay, understood. Now let's try out agile as an experiment in your organization. Now, having set this sponsor, there's one more thing about agile. Agile transformation is not going to be an easy one. It's going to be hard. And it's not the matter of just changing the life cycle. It also means changing your work culture, your engineering practices, or probably even your organization structure. And one more thing, which the risk which I pointed out to the client is, you can generally expect a drop in the productivity, rather the perceived productivity of your people when you start implementing Agile. And you should be prepared for all this. And for that, we need to get a buy-in from the leadership team itself. And that was the next step. How do you get the buy-in? You have set the sponsor's expectations, and how do you get the buy-in? So for that, the leadership needs to understand what exactly Agile means, involves. For me, Agile is not daily stand-up meeting or sprint planning meeting or retrospective. For me, Agile is how well we live up to values and culture. So even before you commit to the Agile transformation, let us see what does these values and principles say first. Understand that and then take a call whether it's applicable to your organization or not. And that's what I told them. And we had a one-day workshop where the sponsor and the entire first-level management, who is directly reporting to the MD, participated in that workshop. And they discussed each and every Agile values and principles. And during this course of exercise, they also came, we did a small exercise. I'm not going to get into details of this exercise. Basically, a business expectations they came out with. What exactly you are expecting from this Agile transformation exercise? And they listed out the business expectations. And then each and every principle they discussed and says, okay, does this principle make sense to meet our business goals? If yes, okay, if no, why not? So I didn't say that you have to implement all the principles, you have to make the people self-organizing. No, we are not even getting into Agile, we're taking a decision whether to go for Agile or not. We are just seeing whether Agile suits our business or not. And incidentally, it so happened that each and every principle was found to be relevant in their business plan. And then they started discussing, okay, if this is the principle with, but there are a lot of constraints, of course, lot. Are we living up to these principles? These were the questions people are asking themselves. If we are not living up to this principle, what else we need to do to live up to this principle? And that's where the buy-in came in. It was a full day exercise, and finally everybody felt, yes, now we should at least explore Agile and see how it happens. Okay. That is the story of the leadership team. But usually in an organization, there is always a big gap between what the leadership says. See, what I'm trying to approach is I was approaching this organization as almost a novice person. I don't know anything about the organization. So I'm assuming that there's going to be a major gap between what leadership thinks and what is the situation exactly in the trenches. So we need to find out where the real work happens, what we call as Jemba. We have to go to the Jemba and see what happens there. And there, that's where we come to the third step. Assess the current scenario. Now, we need to see how the projects are getting executed, how the product is getting developed. So what we did was, we used this Comparative Agility Framework. It is a freely available framework developed by two well-respected Agile gurus, Mike Cohn and Ken Rubin. But we heavily customized this. The idea is they have listed out a lot of practices and they classified under several heads. Our customization was take those practices, maybe change here and there to suit the organization culture. Like for example, a couple of things are straight away deleted. Do we have daily stand-up meetings? I didn't remove the practice itself. Because I know it's not happening, they're entirely new to Agile, so there's no point in keeping. So like that, customization went done. And also these parameters are mapping to, sorry, the practices are mapping into certain parameters. So there are total 38 practices. And these were the 7 parameters which were assessed in the initial stage. And how do we get inputs for this? 2 things. One is release retrospective. Another one is a survey. Now, release retrospective, we had three sessions covering various cross-section of people, but one session was typically the idea, the potential pilot project. And the second session was people from other projects, and third was exclusively for line and project managers. And they kept this, it was a structured retrospective. They kept all these seven stuff in front, and then they did the usual retrospective, which happens, what went right, what is going right, what is didn't go well, what can we do to improve in the previous release. We kept the scope to the previous release. That was one, I facilitated those retrospectives, and that was one input. And another input was a survey questionnaire, which was based on the comparative agility framework. So, but here, I didn't even say that these are agile practices. I said, this is a situation. Now you tell me, how close is your project is to the given situation? Whoever participated in the retrospective, they all responded to this question. So you have to, this is just an example. Parameter is teamwork. It has got four practices associated with it. They have to say how close your project is to the given situation, very far too. So like that, they rated. And the parameter average comes from, parameter rating comes from average of these four practices. This is just a sample. And these practices are taken from that agility assessment framework, which I just showed. And the two pilot candidate projects were taken, they got this ratings in a spider chart. Roughly in a scale of 5, they were between 3 to 3.5. That was the baseline. The purpose of this assessment is not only to compare the practices, but there has got one more agenda. One is to quantitatively know where you stand, what we call as baseline. And probably the most important thing is to surface, are there any critical people issues coming into this organization? Because if certain basic hygiene factors are not satisfied in an organization, people issues, like I'm not happy with my salary is not coming on time, my, sorry, I'm not happy with my boss, I don't have a chair to sit. One place where I was coaching, if I leave my seat for 5 minutes, my seat will be pulled out. I will not get my seat. So such hygiene factors are not satisfied in an organization. I would say that there's no point in starting your agile journey also. First set these things right and then, because agile is discipline and micromanagement. Micromanagement, not by the managers, but self-management and also discipline. So unless you have this hygiene factor satisfied, how are you going to do agile? It's going to backfire. It's better that you be in the existing waterfall model. Probably that would be better in such a situation. But fortunately, no such critical issues surfaced, and we decided, okay, it's a time to start the pilots. But of course, every organization has got certain weaknesses. So these were some of the practices which were requiring attention in the organization. And this is basically 7, 8. What I picked up was, there are certain responses which are rated as far or very far from the given agile practice. And the figures in the bracket indicate how many percentage of the people indicated that as a practice which need attention. Yeah. 3 to 3.5, that is a parameter. I average of team member feedback and also for the pilot project and also the practices associated with the parameters, so averaged and put it in the pivot. Right. Yeah, I'll come to that. Let me finish this presentation because I want to finish it early and so that I can take your questions. Yeah. So, and one more thing is we had assured confidentiality in the retrospectives and also given an option to respond anonymously. So I hope that people responded honestly. And even I have, when you go to an organization with your experience, you can just feel the atmosphere surrounding the organization and can make out, especially if you're doing this for your bread and butter, you generally get an intuitive feeling that whether this organization is okay or not. You will get a good or bad vibes. And fortunately, I didn't get any bad vibes in the organization. So it was good enough to start. It was not perfect, but it was good enough to start. So that's where we need to start, train, and coach the pilot projects. So we chose two pilot projects, which was again with the discussion of the people and the management. What will be the, and so what I ensured was the pilot should be non-trivial. It should not be some hobby project type of project. It should be having some, it's a real life project it should be. And as far, and yeah, as I said, it was a functional organization. So we need to co-locate the developers and testers. So that we made it co-located and gave them the best possible working conditions which they can. Some people will say that, no, you should work with the reality and then find out. That's one thought. But our thought is, given the best situation, what results that the team can show, that will be a demonstration, proof of concept. Therefore, we did that. And also we chose a framework which was derived from Scrum, but not Scrum. It's a Scrum but, you can say. But I don't care whether it's a Scrum but or Scrum derived or a pure Scrum. For me, for us rather, that's the message I was trying to come. Our goal is not to become agile. Our goal is to become effective in our business. And that, for that, whatever means are there, even if it's a waterfall, it's okay for us. So that's why we didn't hang up too much on this Scrum. We derived a lot of good things from Scrum, but certain things, especially we retained the events and practice ceremonies, but we didn't use the Scrum roles. But at the same time, we should respect Scrum also. So if we are deviating from Scrum, we should not say that we are doing Scrum. We may be doing something. So let us not change what is pure Scrum and call it Scrum. So that level of ethics we need to have. And then, so we after that, before we started the pilot, so we had a training for the pilot teams. We had 1 day session for again on agile values and principles and the framework what we are going to use. Well, we quick overview, not the full listing. But more importantly, we had two more trainings. One was teamwork, short sessions, not too extended. Teamwork and role of managers in an agile world. This is to ensure that the managers don't get into command and control mode when the pilot is in progress. And secondly, the team should understand at least the basic concepts of how a teamwork should be done. So with that intention, we had two short workshops but then we didn't have workshops at a stretch. Okay, 3 days from training, after that you do work. No, what I believed was just-in-time, bite-sized training. So before the Scrum starts, the sprint starts, we have a two-day release planning session. First, a little bit of a slide presentation and some exercise training, and then do your actual release planning work. Similarly, just before the sprint planning, after they gave a gap of some days for them to form up the release plans, and then we started the sprint one. When we started the sprint one, just before that, sprint planning training. And we were using our real life work products, not simulated games and exercises. We are not playing games there. We are really using our work products. Games have their place in public courses where it's impossible to have your real life work products in the process, in the training. But when you are training somebody in their own offices, I would prefer to use them to use their own life, work life, what they use in the real life. And then we, so that's how the trainings were given, and I was observing the sprint one where I did the facilitation, but the sprint two onwards, sprint two and three handed it over to the people who are supposed to facilitate, whereas I went into the role of more of a coach, where our focus was to see whether there is a teamwork is being done, whether they are following the agile mindset and the ceremonies. The focus was only on these three, as far as my coaching was concerned. And then, after that, 6 weeks, three sprints. We have to tell what has, how Scrum has affected, no, sorry for using the word Scrum, which was not Scrum. How the Agile way of working has impacted the pilot teams. So for that, we had another survey. This was the same survey, same set of questions for both parameter level and the practice level. But the question was slightly different now. Instead of telling how far you are from the current situation, from the given situation, our question was, ever since you worked in Agile way of working, has certain things become better or worse or remains the same? So we've used only one metric to measure the impact, one type of metric. How many people said that situation has become better? That was our metric to gauge the impact of Agile way of working on the pilot projects. And these were the results of how the perceived impact of Agile on different parameters. Okay, there are different types of people. Some people like to see graphs and some people like to see figures. This is for the people who are more inclined towards pictures, and this same data is projected to the people who are more inclined towards numbers. So these were the parameters, and you would see that 100% of the responses said that our requirements, architecture and design, project planning and monitoring, the continuous improvement culture is better over the last 6 weeks. It's only a 6 weeks results, right? And you can still see teamwork and product quality are also ranking pretty high. Then, if you remember, I had pointed out certain practices which were rated as far from the given situation. That means they are not agile. Okay, this is the, I'm not expecting you to read everything. This is the way we classified all the practices. If you are more than 80% of responses are saying better, we put it in one column. 60 to 80, another column. Less than 60, another column. Don't bother to read it. I'm just going to give this one line result summary of this. That 40% of the 38 practices were rated as better in the post-pilot survey by more than 80% of the respondents. So that is the impact. That's the way we could measure the impact what Agile way of working is creating in the pilot projects. Okay, now let's come to the practices which were rated slightly on the lower side in the pre-pilot survey. Yeah, the same results in terms of numbers. Everybody agreed that visibility of the progress is now much, much better, 100% unanimous. Tester getting involved is also very high. Earlier, they were working in silos. Now they're really appreciating that, okay, developer and testers are sitting together and working. Team behavior is getting encouraged. So like that, these were the things. Even the lower responses are actually, they are better response. 36% said that technical debt is better. But let us focus on what has happened, what was the strong points. Okay, so I'm almost coming to an end of my MVP, that is minimum viable presentation. And so your question will be, so all these results were presented to the sponsor and the leadership team and even the pilot projects. And the decision was, yes, Agile way of working is helping us. So now let's bring 8 more projects into the Agile purview. What I'm talking about here in this presentation is not the complete transformation. Journey still goes on. I'm just talking about how well you initiate a transformation. If you are still in early stage, there are a lot of things to do. Then again, my involvement is not there full time. I'm not a full time coach there. After this pilot, my involvement became less. I started focusing on other projects, not on the project which did the pilot. Okay. So it's always a danger that it might slip back to the older ways of working. So for the 8 projects which we took up, we followed a similar projects, and they went through the same cycle what I described for this particular project. But we also took a survey after almost 1 year on the pilot projects, how things are impacting them. So this time we made the survey a little bit more, cover a little bit more ground. We did some more customization. We evaluated some 11 parameters, and this is the results after 1 year in the same project. I've not told you all the information here. I'm expecting the questions will answer that. So this was the impact which was created in the same project after 1 year. So that finishes my presentation. Now you can ask questions, or you can go for a early lunch. Floor is open. Yeah. Yeah. Okay. Yeah, very good question. Because unless you improve your engineering practices, you cannot take full benefit of Agile. And this particular organization, they were following certain practices, and many organizations takes a different route. Some people want to improve their project management practices, some people want to engineering. Some of this organization was, they felt that, okay, they have other dependencies. So engineering practices, they have not much scope of improvement. So we focused on the management and other process part of it. But every time I've been stressing that Agile will take this, all these things will take you only to a certain level. If you have to go further in the agility scale, you have to improve your engineering practice, like test automation, then breaking down vertical slices. So those are the things, and try to finish all the stories. But then it's a company's choice. Your goal is not to become Agile, your goal is to get the business results. So if you're comfortable with a certain level of practices and it's working well for you, whom I have to force them? But at least I made my opinion and my share the best practices. Sorry, best practices, again a wrong word, but a good practices of the industry, that okay, without engineering practices, Agile can go only a certain level. To get the maximum benefit of Agile, you need to improve engineering. But if you still see, there are 33% people are still saying it's better. Yeah. Product. Okay, these are all survey. So there is no, we didn't introduce the velocity and those concepts, because it is just their perception and their. So we say that product is, yeah, the what has happened is, yeah, I'm coming to the issues which happened. The people felt that the productivity was reducing. So at least the product managers, they felt the productivity was reducing. And that had already been stressed with the fact that your productivity might drop. But then that productivity is sort of a perceived productivity, because developer does something, it works on a machine. Oh, you are productive. But it has not been tested. So that was taking time, and that was giving a perception that people are not productive. But after 3 months, that release cycle, they felt, oh, okay, though that time we felt that we are not productive, but we are actually more productive. That's what the senior manager said, that yeah, initially felt that we are not productive, but now we are. Yeah, but still, still there is a scope of improvement. It's not that it is fully productive. Okay, I think time is. Some of my alarm didn't ring. Thanks.